somewhere, somehow, this man needs to be stopped. And I hope, I certainly hope that we get some news on Ric Flair in this program, and somehow, some way, that match at Starrcade in only 6 days can take place. But I don't, you know, I mean, the man, last time we heard, suffered a heart attack. I don't see how he could, but that match is still on, as we said here right now.
Tony, this past Thursday in Charlotte, North Carolina, had to be the most disappointing and most disgusting situation that I have ever been involved with in professional wrestling. To think that Eric Bischoff, on the guise of inviting the Flair family to the ring in Charlotte, North Carolina, their own hometown, to apologize to them face to face, and then to turn the troops loose on Flair's own family, his son David, his son Reed, his wife Beth sitting at ringside, the most disappointing thing that I've ever been involved with in pro wrestling.
You know, you can change the cover of a book a zillion times. Shut it, you peasant. Bischoff can come out and make some kind of facade, cut his hair, apologize, but inside, we have a heartless, evil man.
Fit Finley and Scott Putski in this opening bout, fans, and well, in the face of all of this, Starrcade is shaping up to be one of the grandest of the granddaddy of them all, and certainly we've been talking a lot during the past couple of weeks about Goldberg and Big Sexy Kevin Nash. We've often said, even before the match was signed, even before Kevin Nash went on to dominate World War III and win the 60-man three-ring battle royal to secure his spot on the 27th, we often said that if there was one man we thought could take Goldberg down, it was Kevin Nash, who had the size. And here's another thing about Kevin Nash that I feel that's in his court going into Starrcade. I think of all the wrestlers, you look at Kevin Nash, and truly, the man is not intimidated by Goldberg when most people have been. And that's a really key point heading to Starrcade.
Kevin Nash has been there before, in addition to the size that he brings to the ring. Among the biggest opponents that Goldberg has ever faced upcoming at Starrcade, he also has a huge experience edge over the unbeaten world's heavyweight champion.
See, that experience edge boils down to one thing, and that's confidence. Nash is a very, very confident man, and that is one of the main secrets of success.
Finley with a back elbow on young Scott Putski. Yeah, it's easy to forget that Goldberg's only been in this sport over a year now. I mean, he's been so dominant. He has been truly the man, and deservedly so, because he has just run over all his opponents. But you seem to forget that it was September of 1997 that Goldberg first arrived on the scene. No one has risen as quickly as Goldberg into the spotlight, into superstardom. Kevin Nash has the shot on Sunday night to become the world champ. But, and I know becoming the world champ is a goal for every wrestler, but to be the man, to be the first man to defeat Goldberg is something everyone has wanted to do. And Kevin Nash is standing on deck, getting ready to step up to the batter's box coming on Sunday night.
You know, it's amazing to me, after 20 glorious years where a reputation has become just as valuable as the gold belt itself.
And in the corner, that's Fit Finley. Here comes the shot. Running over Fit Finley, the fans erupt here. You can see in this massive TWA drop that we have just a phenomenal crowd on hand. We are going to give you the number. Professional wrestling in St. Louis.
Wow, what a statement that is when you think about the history of professional wrestling through the years in St. Louis, this tradition-rich stronghold of the sport.
Here's Scott Putski showing some power of his own. Fit Finley goes down hard. Putski with a head of steam. Young man with an elbow drop. Here's a cover. One, two, and a kicking away is Fit Finley. Had a chance to talk to Scott's father, Ivan Putski, when we were in Houston a few weeks ago, and he's very proud of this young man. Certainly a much different type of wrestler, but I really think Scott has a lot of attributes that his father never had, Larry.
Yeah, well, he's a lot quicker. He knows more moves, better movement than his father, and he's got the power in his genes. But again, like we talk about Nash and Goldberg, Finley has got the experience. And in this match, Finley is a very confident man.
Scott Putski, paying homage to tradition, has Polish power, his father's nickname, across the top of his sights. And he's been using that double sledge that Ivan Putski made famous, the Polish hammer.
Well, those birds on his legs is Polish falcon.
You would know that.
Yes, I would. I'm telling you, it's the Polish falcon.
Rear chin lock here by Scott Punchke. So many great matches. We talked about the triangle match coming up at Starrcade for the Cruiserweight belt. You know about Saturn and his match against the Cat, but what about what DDP has ahead of him? Diamond Dallas Page, who has endured so much, and I'm talking about injury-wise from so many men, but when you remember the visions of those repeated choke slams on the top turnbuckle, and then tack on to that, guys, what happened a week ago when the Giant came unglued and tried to end DDP's career and almost did by chokeslamming the man through the platform behind the set piece.
The whole set came unglued. Compliments of DDP's body.
And the Giant when he dismantled the letters from WCW before that chokeslam. But who bounces back better from adversity than DDP Diamond Dallas Page? And he's going to have to this Sunday at Starrcade.
That's the big point, he's going to have to, because it's not just any man. And I tell you right now, the Giant is as angrier than we've ever seen. And he already, because of his size and his ability, is one of the most dangerous men ever in our sport. But now the picture's a lateral press and a nice one. One, two, the fact that the Giant has this demeanor about him as a tough in this man's career makes for a very intriguing, to say the least, matchup coming up at Starrcade. DDP and the Giant on the 27th in the nation's capital at the biggest, the legendary wrestling event that it is, Starrcade 1998.
And DDP can't ever forget David brought down Goliath using his brains.
And that's what he's going to have to do, and one of the using his brains. Finley and young Scott Punchke. I think Finley may be surprised that Punchke's given him this much of a match, and I say that because of the he wants to shake his hand, and Punchke's not buying this law.
Well, Finley wants to change the tide here. He's going to start a psychological warfare. Again, the physical nature of Punchke's been keeping right up with Finley, and now he's trying to outsmart the kid.
There's a pickup now.
And he did.
And a big atomic drop that time by Fit Finley. And stomping away on the chest. The 27th of December has everybody talking. And I really think that you're going to see more press, more members of the media surrounding this world title match than there's ever been. And you think about how many of the grand champions have held the belt. I mean, you take the roots of this belt all the way back to the year 1905. One, two, a two count. And all the great champions in this city who have defended the world title, never before has there been a title match like we've got coming up at Starrcade with so much talk. And if you add that to the fact that Goldberg is going to be here tonight right up against Scott Hall, who has attempted, and I'm going to repeat this again, Mike, today, it's very apparent, adhere himself to the Wolfpack. And I really think that Scott Hall is going to try to prove some sort of a point here tonight. And that could be very dangerous for the world champ Goldberg on the 6 days before his world title match against Kevin Nash.
Well, on the surface, you'd be surprised that Goldberg would go into the ring against Scott Hall inside 1 week away from that title defense against Kevin Nash. But I guess we really shouldn't be surprised, because it's what we've come to expect from Goldberg.
And it's what we've come to expect from WCW Monday Nitro. This is the program that changed the face of pro wrestling.
Finley just changed his face.
He hit the ring pumps very hard, and we're very proud to be a part of this on this historic night in one of the legendary cities of St. Louis, Missouri, up on top here. Scott Punchke getting a second win.
Oh, hey, Punchke's pulling ahead on points here.
Here's a scoop slam, nicely done by, could be the Polish Hammer.
What we talked about earlier, this is a throwback move to his father.
And listen to the fans now when he matched. He missed the Polish Hammer, and oh my, got caught. Fit Finley for a roll slam.
Great preparation. Finley was ready for the move, ducked it, and answered with one of his own.
Here's where experience comes in. We knew it was coming from Scott Punchke. He was ready for it, and he just cranked them.
Tombstone pile driver. This one's over. Quite a matchup. I would say very evenly matched. And Fit Finley, the former World of Television champion, shows us that he can endure a lot